Sorry, Father. I might be bothering you.
You're giving me orders? What makes you think I'll do what you want? Your friend here is totally crazy, you know.
I'm not kidding.
Yeah, serious.
Here are my conditions. First, say nothing about this to Lawrence. And second, you'll tag with me wherever I go.
Oh, look, Axel, you'd better leave me alone. I'll never do what you want. Now go away.
Listen, Cello, I'm sure you know how hard it is to study without notes. How will you study for the test, hmm? And about this notebook.
Oops.
Give that back to me. That's mine. Give it back. Give it back. Come on.
That's what I'm saying. Please.
Cello, if you keep acting this way, you'll never get your notes back. Hey, where are you going?
To the principal's office.
Oh, really? What do you think the principal can do now, huh? And besides, what proof do you have that my friends and I took your notes? What will you do now? So, are you going to go and tell your best friend, that guy who made you cry? I know that you're not speaking to him. Listen, here's the deal. Nobody can know about this. You'd better give me an answer tomorrow, okay?
I really think that Lupe's Canteen is the best name for it. It fits the place.
No, let's name it after Cello instead. She's our lucky charm, Cello's Canteen.
Mother, Father.
Bless you, my child. I've got good news. We have the permit to open the theater.
That's good to know.
Finally, we can open the theater. And your father and I have been talking about putting up a canteen in the theater. We will name it after you.
Hey, what's wrong, Cello? Do you have a problem?
No, I'm all right, Father. It's just that I had a lot to do in school.
Graduating students like you have so much to do. Listen, Cello. Don't push yourself too hard. You might get sick.
Your mother is right. Now, Cello. Take it easy, okay? You're a very smart girl, and I'm sure you'll be named class valedictorian. Mm-hmm. I'll bet no one even comes close.
By the way, a letter arrived for you. It's from Gian. I put it in your bedroom.
Really, Mother? Okay, I'll take a look at it.
All right.
Dear Lawrence, you know what? Cello wrote me a letter. She told me she's avoiding you because you're annoying. But seriously, Lawrence, if you have any kind of problem, just try to solve it on your own. And don't give up on Cello. Cello, don't worry. I wrote to Lawrence and told him what you said to me. He knows how serious you really are about your studies. But I wish you'd tell him yourself that school is your first priority.
Dear Gian, Cello and I had a big argument yesterday. We said very hurtful things to one another. But you're right. She and I should work harder to resolve this problem between us. I'm willing to be the one to give in and try to understand. I'll do it because I don't want to lose my best friend.
I know that I've hurt Lawrence. But then sometimes, Gian, you have to do things you don't want to do because you know it's going to hurt the other person. But you have no choice. It has to be done. Do you know what I mean? You have to sacrifice something knowing it will be for the greater good. I know. It's confusing, but I hope that you'll understand. I really miss you. If you were here with me, I'd have someone to console me. I wish you'd come back home.
Third condition. You will be the muse of my team.
Shello. Shello, I'm really sorry.
I need an answer right now, Shello.
Okay, Axel. I'll do it. I'll be the muse of your team at the game.
Shello. Shello!
Dear Lawrence, it won't be long now before I finally come home. My Aunt Deli passed away. I have no one now. I'm all alone in the world. I have no other family aside from you. I hope you and Shella will be friends again. You two are the only ones who really care about me. So please stop fighting.
Dear Gian, you have my deepest sympathies. Don't you worry. Since we were young, I've always thought of you as a brother. And I'm pretty certain that's how Shella thinks of you too. But you know, Gian, it seems there's nothing more I can do. It seems the world has turned upside down. And Shella? Well, she's always with Axel now. Hanging out with him and his gang wherever they go.
We can still stay friends, Gian, even if things between Lawrence and I aren't going well. I think it's better this way. I have fewer problems now.
I don't know why you're spending so much time with Axel these days. But I'm sure you have your reasons, whatever they are. But then, Shello, there's one thing I learned from the loss of my Aunt Deli. In this world, and in this life that we live in, there really is nothing that is more important than being with those you love and those who love you.
You couldn't get there.
Here. Fast, fast, fast.
Here, come on.
Come on. Yeah.
Come on, give it a nice
shot. Go.
Yeah.
What's that? Yeah.
Hey, guys. We don't need to practice.
Why not?
What's going on here?
Because we're way too good already.
Yeah, that's true.
Why are you here? Is there a problem?
There is. It's you.
Yeah? Well, bring it on. This is about Shella, right? Huh?
Don't drag her into this.
Lawrence, even if you win, she's not going to go back to you because she's mine now.
What have you done to her, huh?
What do you mean by that, huh?
I know. I know you had a hand in this.
Oh, you think so?
Tell me what you did to her. What?
Why are you accusing me when I did nothing? Nothing at all.
We had an agreement. You said you'd leave her alone. But now you broke your promise!
Hey, now, you're the one who broke your promise. You made her cry, you know. And besides, it was her decision to hang out with me. Ask her yourself.
Shello. Is it true? Is it your decision to be with Axel? Is this what you really want, Shello?
Yes. I'm sorry, Lawrence.
Cello! Cello!
Lawrence, come here. I want to introduce you. This is my son, Lawrence.
Hi, Mother.
Hi, son. These ladies you already know.
Yeah,
but I don't believe you have met Lolita. Lolita, this is my son, Lawrence.
Hi. Nice to meet you. Excuse me, Mother. I just need to go to my room.
Why, son? Homework again?
How lucky you are here in Monte Gracia. And what a very hard-working and responsible boy our future mayor is. Mm.
You're so right. Compared to other teenagers out there who do nothing but show off and make trouble, I'm glad there are still nice boys like him.
Thank you, ma'am. Excuse me, Mother. Excuse me, ladies.
Okay, see you later.
All right.
Why did you do that, Cello?
I just saw a bug, but it's really nothing. Nothing to worry about, Father.
Okay, call your mother so that we can all have dinner. I'll set the table right now.
Okay.
Lawrence?
Yes?
Lawrence, sweetheart, dinner is ready.
I'm really not hungry.
Is there a problem, son?
No.
Hey. I can tell when something's wrong with you. If there's a problem, why don't you tell me? You know how I worry when I see that you're upset. And who knows? I might actually be able to help you out.
All right, it's Cello. I just don't understand. Why all of a sudden, she's very different. She's avoiding me now.
You can't really force anyone to like you if they really don't, right?
Mother, I'm Cello's best friend. She's really important to me. And aside from you, she's one of the reasons why I decided to come back to Monte Gracia.
I'm getting jealous of her already.
Mother.
Just kidding, okay? Why don't you reach out to her? Why don't you do something that you know will make her happy? Surprise her. Give her white roses.
I tried that already. But...
But what? Don't give up. Try to win her back at all costs. Whatever it takes, if she really means that much to you.
Here. Dinner's ready.
Ah, nice and hot. Thank you, Cello. Thank you, Cello.
Cello, so how is Lawrence? What? Remember what I said could happen to you?
Lupe.
Well, I've noticed that he hasn't been coming over to visit us anymore. Remember what I once told you? I said to be ready because who knows what could happen. His mother, Frida, can stir up trouble for you. She's capable of doing things that a well-bred woman shouldn't be doing.
Lupe, just what have you been telling our daughter? Cello, just remember this. A real friendship is worth fighting for.
Father, up to what point should a person fight for that friendship?
Well, if that friend means the world to you, there is no limit.
What about you? Isn't it true that when Ernesto married Frida, you drifted apart from him?
It's true, I know. But I still treated him like a close friend. Shello, I didn't deliberately put an end to our friendship after he got married. Things just changed. It was difficult, but I learned to adjust.
Essang, not everyone is a martyr like you. Shello, I know your friend is very important to you. But if I were you, I'd think about being the one to give up on Lawrence so that you won't get hurt and end up looking like a fool, understand?
That Frida. Better not try anything that will hurt my one and only precious girl.
Don't you worry now, Father. That isn't going to happen. We won't be bothered anymore by Dr. Frida. I only hope she's a woman of her word.
What's happening between us, Shello? If only things were how it used to be.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Jian!
What's going on?
You just vanished from this place all of a sudden one day, and then you reappear without my knowing it.
What?
I thought I lost this.
That Shello's ring. It's still with you? When are you going to give it back to Shello?
This ring has really been through a lot with me. But I will return it. Maybe on prom night. But I think that maybe it just won't happen.
Lawrence, take it easy, pal. This peace officer will take care of it all for you. Good night. I'm just too tired from the trip.
You're going back to bed?
I still have jet lag, you know.
I sure hope they like this recipe.
I'm sure they will.
It's quite delicious.
Mother, Father, I'm off to school.
Take care, Shello.
I will.
But wait, where is your bag for school?
Well, it's just sports day today. The bag is so heavy, so I decided to leave it. Mother, please don't forget to please repair my skirt, okay?
Absolutely, Shello. You better go now. You don't want to be late.
Okay, bye.
Jian, you're going back to school?
But of course. I've been away for too long, and besides, I really need to go and have a talk with my advisor today. And I have to do something for you, right?
Do a good job, okay? I know she'll listen to you.
Hey, Lawrence, aren't you running late?
Oh, good morning, Uncle.
Good morning. By the way, are you going back to school?
Yes, sir.
Good. Don't you worry. All you need to do is take a makeup exam and everything will be all right again. I'm glad you're back, Jian.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Well now, yes. Going to school?
Yes, and we have to go now.
Have a great day.
We'll Goodbye. Be leaving now, Uncle.
Father?
Right. Goodbye now.
Josefa, please bring out Ernesto's vitamins.
Jian, I didn't know you were back. How
Cello.
Are you?
Huh? You missed me, didn't you?
Yes, of course. Oh, my condolences to you, Jian.
Thanks a lot. Cello, this is for you.
Wow, thanks. Well, now, is this from Samar?
No, it's from Lawrence. So, what's wrong? Cello, Lawrence told me to tell you that if you accept this, then it means that you still value the friendship between you. And if you're still mad at him, he hopes that you patch things up.
Jian, listen. It's not that simple.
Yeah, come on. No, no, no. We bet on that.
What? I don't remember betting.
We'll leave you two alone.
Well, go ahead, man.
Bye.
Good luck.
See you later, Axel.
Let's go. Axel.
What is it?
I was told to report to the principal's office.
Just don't forget, huh? I'm expecting you at the game.
And I'm expecting you to return my bag. See
you. Hey, Axel.
Hey.
Your friends are getting hungry.
Yeah.
It's time you treat us.
Well, let's go. Come on, guys.
Yeah.
What do you guys want?
I'd like cake.
I have a lot of faith in you, Lawrence. I know that you can do it. I've been inviting you to join us. But you opted to play chess. Instead of basketball.
I've changed since then.
Okay. But I think the team finished practicing. You practice on your own, kid. And I hope you don't let me down. Okay?
Thank you, coach.
All right.
Lawrence.
I gathered all of you here to inform you that Dr. Frieda is going to pay us a visit later. She's trying to get some feedback on our scholarship program, and she will observe and assess you to see if our methods are still effective. It's likely that she'll even look at your grades. Okay, but don't be nervous. What's important is that you know the answers to all her questions.
Just a while.
Okay, Dr. Frieda, I'll leave you both to talk. Shall I?
Okay, ma'am.
Well, I suppose you have an idea why I wanted to talk to you alone. How are you, Shello?
I'm fine, ma'am, thank you.
And how are you coming along with our agreement?
I kept my promise, ma'am. You can even ask your son, Lawrence. I hope you'll keep your word, too.
I always keep my word, as long as I'm not provoked. Do I make myself very clear? You know very well what will happen, Shello, should you break the agreement you made with me.
Ma'am, I'm finished. Thank you.
Okay.
Myrna, he's lucky he's being protected by the mayor and Dr. Frieda, huh? Come to think of it, who owns the school anyway?
Shh, be quiet.
Well, it's true. And you know, Dr. Frieda doesn't hesitate to flaunt her power and influence here. It's true.
Shello, tell me the truth right now. Is Aunt Frieda the person behind your fight with Lawrence? What did she tell you? Shello, I want you to tell me. What did Aunt Frieda really say to you?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? I saw the two of you today. I saw you both come out of the principal's office. You were in there with her.
I wasn't the only person she spoke to. She spoke to the other scholars. She was just getting feedback on her, scholarship program.
Shello, sorry. But you and I both know that she's always hated you. You know that, don't you? And about the theater. It's not over, is it? Shello, you know Lawrence well. You know he hasn't done anything wrong. You've been through a lot together. Why give up on him now? When he hasn't even done anything wrong to you?
He has. Lots of things. I don't need to tell you what he's done to me. If he honestly thinks of me as a friend, he'll know what I'm feeling. He should respect my decision. I want us to go our separate ways.
Shello, how can he know what you're feeling if it don't make him understand?
I'm leaving now, Gian.
Wait, I'm coming with you. We're not done yet, Shello. Lawrence! Lawrence!
I overheard your conversation. You think my mother's involved?
Lawrence, I'm sorry, but then...
Don't worry about it. I know how upset you are about me and Shello, right? That's why you're looking for an explanation. But you know, Gian? You heard it from Shello herself. Let's just leave her alone, okay?
Shello. You know, Lawrence has been down lately. I'm not taking sides with anyone here, but I really wish the two of you would stop fighting and make up. You're both very important to me, and I just want to see you happy.
Jihan.
Shello. Please don't push Lawrence aside. He's very important to you. I lost someone important. And it hurts a lot. A lot. It's true.
Jihan, there are decisions that are difficult to make. Things you may one day regret, and that's when you realize you were completely wrong. You know it will hurt. But then you still need to do it. Because you know that it's the right thing to do.
So you wormed your way into my team. Just what are you trying to prove?
I just accepted the offer of the coach.
We finalized our lineup, so we don't need you.
Coach decided. What do you want me to do?
The team has no use for you. We don't like you at all.
I know.
If you want to get back with Shello, it's too late. But if all you really want to do is show off, you'd better think twice, Lawrence.
I really don't care what you think, Axel. Whether you like it or not, I'm going to play.
Don't tell me I didn't warn you.
Jihan.
Huh? Oh, good evening, Uncle Ernesto.
Good evening. Can I have a word with you for a minute? There's something I want to tell you. Join me in the study. You know, Jihan, I am really sad about your Aunt Delia's death. But at the same time, I'm happy because, well, you're back here. By the way, this Saturday, well, you know the drill. I'm going to District 7.
You know, Uncle Ernesto, about that thing concerning, well, you know, Aunt Melba. You see, I'm starting to feel guilty, especially towards Lawrence. I don't want the time to come when he may get mad at me.
Listen, Gian. I understand completely. Yes, I understand just how important you consider your friendship with my son, Lawrence. However, by now you should already know, without a doubt, that you owe me your complete loyalty. I don't have to remind you how good I've taken care of you. And, all I'm asking in exchange is a very small favor from you. One more thing. Just like I've said before, I don't want anyone at all to know about this, because if that happens, I'll know it came from you, and you're gonna pay for it. That's why we have to be really careful about this. Okay, then. You'd better get going now, or otherwise, you might get in trouble with your Aunt Frida.
Lawrence, you're joining the sports fist, right? I saw you talking to the coach today.
Is that wrong?
Of course not, but then... won't that make you Axel's teammate?
So what? We have to be on the same team, because we're in the same year level.
Lawrence, just admit it. Shella's the real reason why you joined.
Okay. I want her to know that I'm not affected by this anymore. If she really wants to be with that stupid bully Axel, okay, fine. What can I do and why should I care?
Lawrence, you know, you shouldn't be stubborn. You won't prove anything and nothing will get done.
Gian, I really don't demand too much from a friend. Just complete honesty. But Shello, she can't even give me that. That's why I'm so thankful that you're here. Because I know you're always honest with me.
Cello, I finished working on your skirt. It's time for bed now, okay? Nobody wants a muse with eye bags.
I don't want to be a muse in the first place. In fact, Mother, I want to back out of it.
What? But why, Cello? You deserve to be the team's muse, you know. Ah, I understand. I know what you're thinking. You really never cared much for beauty contests, am I right? But you've agreed to do this one, so you really have to give it your best, okay? You have to keep your word, Cello. Oh, so time for bed now, my beautiful daughter.
All right, I'll sleep now.
Go on to sleep.
Okay, Mother.
Sweet dreams.
Going to do? I'm so late. Oh gosh. Oh no, what have I brought here? Oh dear. Axel, what are you doing here? This place is for girls. I'm going to scream. I mean it.
Relax, I just wanted to give you this. I think this will fit you, so you should wear it. And I brought some makeup. Put some on, so you won't look so pale.
How dare you say those things to me now? You blackmailed me into doing this, and then now you're insulting me, huh? For your information, my mother repaired this skirt for me, so I'm wearing this, not that.
Yeah, I know that, but that's an ugly skirt. This will look better on you.
Honey, you really have a lot of nerve, you know that?
Do you think I'm like your gang of idiots? Well, I'm not like Jess, huh? I can't be bribed the way they can. I'm just not that kind of person.
People will see us together later, so I want you to look cool like me. I don't want to be seen with a girl who isn't cool. And remember, today's the day you'll get your bag back, right?
Dare try to go back on your promise to me, or else I'll make you regret it.
Shello, please.
Let me have that. I'm wearing the skirt my mother repaired, not the one that you brought. Wait there.
Hey, what are you doing here? This bathroom is for girls. Come on, the game's about to start. We're waiting for you.
I'm waiting for Shiloh to finish changing.
Shiloh?
Well, what's wrong?
Hey, where's Axel? Is he back yet?
Axel,
what about you?
She's not here either. But don't worry, I'm sure she'll
be. I hope you're right. Make it good, boys. Yeah, don't let me down, okay? Yeah. Remember,
hurry.
Play good defense.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's go. Come on.
You can do it.
Let's all welcome the freshman team! Give a hand for the sophomores!
Look at that!
And now, the juniors! Last but not the least, the seniors!
Okay, boys, we've been training long and hard for this game. I want you to go out there and win it. Don't let me down, okay? You'll play center and you'll be here, okay?
Okay.
Okay, he can do that.
Okay, come on.
Okay, game.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, go! Good luck, boys. Show him what you got. Boys, I want you to listen to me. I'm not seeing any teamwork out there, understand? Work as a team.
As a team.
And no fighting over the ball. Are we clear on that? Uh-huh. Okay, let's go.
Yes,
Axel, Lawrence, what's wrong with you? Let's go.
1, 2, 3, go.
Go! Come on. Play ball.
Hey, come on. 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 Come on
Axel, are you okay? What?
Those two guys.
Lawrence is mad.
You know what, Lawrence? You never really use that brain of yours. No matter what happens, you always let your anger get the best of you.
Oh. For once, I agree with
you. Yeah, whatever.
Fighting.